أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم جنات عدن يدخلونها يحلون فيها من أساور من ذهب ولؤلؤا ولباسهم فيها حرير وقالوا الحمد لله الذي أذهب عنا الحزن إن ربنا لغفور شكور
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Assalamu alaikum dear brothers and sisters and welcome back to another episode on my Ramadan series, A Drop of Wisdom.
شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان.
This dua is very beautiful because it was made by the dwellers of paradise. When they enter paradise, they will be adorned with bracelets made of gold and pearls, and they will be given gowns made of silk. And then they will say, Alhamdulillah alladhi adhaba 'anna al-hazan, inna rabbana laghafurun shakur. All praise and thanks is to Allah who has removed the grief from us. And indeed, our Lord is the most forgiving and the most ready to appreciate. SubhanAllah, it is a very short dua, but very powerful and meaningful. And now let's look into Surah Ghafir, where there are three other very beautiful Rabbana du'as. So the angels will be making dua for the believers, the angels who bear the throne of the Almighty. And they will say, رَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً وَعِلْمًا فَاغْفِرْ لِلَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَاتَّبَعُوا سَبِيلَكَ وَقِهِمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ. Our Lord, you comprehend things from your mercy and your knowledge. So forgive the ones who repent and follow your path and save them from the torment of the blazing fire.
رَبَّنَا وَأَدْخِلْهُمْ جَنَّاتِ عَدْنٍ الَّتِي وَعَدْتَهُمْ وَمَنْ صَلَحَ مِنْ آبَائِهِمْ وَأَزْوَاجِهِمْ وَذُرِّيَّاتِهِمْ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ.
Our Lord, enter them into the eternal gardens as you have promised, the righteous ones from amongst their fathers, their wives, and their offspring. And indeed, you are the Almighty and the Most Wise.
وَقِهِمُ السَّيِّئَاتِ وَمَنْ تَقِ السَّيِّئَاتِ يَوْمَئِذٍ فَقَدْ رَحِمْتَهُ وَذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ.
And save them from the sins. And on that day, those who you save from the sins will be taken into your mercy. And indeed, this is the best type of success. So, subhanAllah, even the angels will be making dua for the mu'minun and the mu'minat. And definitely, we want to be a part of the angels' du'as. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded the angels that are most close and beloved to Him to make dua for the believers in their absence. So it is part of the angel's nature to say Ameen whenever a Muslim makes dua for his brother. And I want to mention a beautiful Sahih hadith over here.
إِذَا دَعَ الْمُسْلِمْ لِأَخِيهِ بِظَهْرِ الْغَيْبِ قَالَ الْمَلَكُ أَمِينْ وَلَكَ بِمِثْلِهِ.
When a Muslim makes dua for his brother in his absence, the angels say, Ameen, and same for you. And inshallah, I hope we all are always in the angels' dua as well.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Alladhina yahmiluna al-arsh wa man hawlahu. يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم وقهم السيئات ومن تق السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته وذلك هو الفوز العظيم.
Inshallah, I will see you all next time on my Ramadan series, A Drop of Wisdom, where we can discuss something beautiful from the Holy Quran once again. Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. Stay tuned and see you next time.